I'm going to start off, you know, you're back in America now, and, you know, things have changed, obviously, for you guys from the last time you were here. So for those that you're introducing yourself to still in the States, give us a little backstory. How did you guys form?
Well, you know, we are actually a duo. It's me and Lars.
Right.
We are creating the music and our universe, what you call it. It's our little thing. And for live, we bring in friends, good friends, and great musicians. So we have a horn section. We are six when we play live. And the guys also play on the album. But, you know, we present the music for them, and then they play it, and we're like a big family, like a collage, like a collective, you can say it, for life and for travel and in general. But we are a duo, but it's not hired guns, you know, it's kind of a hippie kind of vibe.
Very
cool. And, you know, we play pop music, and, we just love to play and travel, see the world, and get to meet people, and our first album is out, and we're so pleased and so happy that we have the opportunity to release an album, and hopefully people will get something from it and feel something, happy, angry, sad, excited, all things, you know. We like to give people a good experience for live and when they listen to the album, and yeah.
Very cool. So, you know, because your music is so much fun and so energetic and very different, who came up with the idea between you and Lars to create a two-piece psychedelic pop dance fusion? Or was that just something that you guys just wanted to do and just try a bunch of different stuff altogether from the beginning?
Yeah, well, you know, me and Lars, we have been friends for years, and we actually played together before, you know, nothing serious in that way. But then one day, Lars called me and said, hey, he had done some sketches, and he had built a small home studio. And I listened to it, and I thought it was absolutely amazing, the sound he was able to create. And it was just the sound I had in my head. I was doing something else as well, and we decided to work on it. And we just met in the summer of 2007 in his one-room apartment, worked and cut through the music and brought in all we wanted and tried out different things. We continued producing on it. You know, Lars is the producer of the album until we had to master it. So because it was the first album, we had a long process doing it, you know. That's tough as well.
Right.
It's really cool. And we were just, you know, both of us, we work really well together. We are very different, but we come in with ideas that really fit together and make it fresh for each other. And, you know, we trust each other. When if Lars finds something, I kind of almost always like it, and the opposite. So we bring in different things, and yet we don't argue that much about that. It's just like, yeah. And we're like really, you know, woo, about only being two people, you know, because it's just fit. You know, sometimes if you're a band and you're 1 million people in a band, it can be frustrating to get your things through. And we can do that, the two of us. Last place, many instruments, and we can work in the studio, so we are very much our own, and it's good to be less and agree on a lot but bring in different things, so it works really cool for us. And we think the band is very special, all of them. They bring a vibe to it live, and we're good friends, so we think we got the best of two different worlds, if you can say that.
Right. I love the philosophy behind it. I think it's a great idea, you know. So when you guys were starting off, you started off in Copenhagen, your hometown, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what was going on in that city at the time of your formation that musically that made you guys want to break the mold of what that type of sound? Was there anything coming out of Copenhagen that was so special or so different that inspired you to fall into this way, or was it just fun that you wanted to have?
Well, you know, I really like that you say you think it's special and its own, because I feel that as well. You know, it draws references from many different periods and genres. But I think one of the reasons why we sound like we do is, of course, because of me and Lars, but also because we were so sick and tired of everything sounding the same. It was like, you know, electronic, indie rock, indie whatever. It was so... we wanted something soulful. We wanted something warmer, and you know, pop music, it can be really tough doing pop music because these days, you know, it's like, oh, indie is the right thing, and you know what I mean? We wanted to say we love pop music and we can sing about happy things and we can sing about sad things. So we wanted to mix it. So we have all of it in our music, and that means that we don't have to be happy all the time. We don't have to be sad all the time. You know, we have everything in our music, so whatever we feel like, it's okay. You know, some bands, they have this and they have to smash a guitar at every show because they did that once, you know?
Mm-hmm.
For us, it's... I think we just wanted to do something else.
Cool.
So, and I don't know if it's something else, but, you know, as you said, you think it's special, so... It might be something else.
Well,
we did something, and this was what came out of it. So we didn't think that much about it. Of course we did, but we say, oh, we want to sound like Prince, or we want to be the new U2, or, you know, it's not about that. It's just about trying to do something, and suddenly you made something, and it came out that way.
Well, you made it, and it came out so well that, in fact, your demo got right to Amy Winehouse right after you guys formed, and you opened up for her in Denmark. So what was that experience like? You know, you here you are, this new band, making this new sound, something very special, and now your special music got to one of the world's biggest pop stars, and she requests that you open for her. What was that experience like for you?
Well, you know, I think the thing was that her management, they heard our music, and because she played in Copenhagen, and we were a new local band, you know, we haven't played before, then they thought it could be cool because we were a new band and we had to start somewhere. We had a booking agency at that time, and we were like, okay, shit, let's do it. You know, it was a great opportunity to get your music out, and we had to gather the band because we hadn't done it all at that point. So we quickly gathered the band and we rehearsed one or two times, and then we played like 20 minutes. And that was it. It's a great experience, you know, just to say, okay, you don't be afraid, you know, you just have to jump right into it. And I guess we were lucky that we had the chance to play for many people, and people got to know us. And it you know, you have to be formed the hard way, you know. It's cool to keep your tongue straight in your mouth, you know.
Right. That's very true. Because I mean, Amy Winehouse then obviously opened up just that gig afterwards. Things started opening up for you even more. And your song, Around the Bend, then was featured on the iPod commercial. And so what was that like hearing your first...
Well, you know, I think it was really crazy shit. Because, you know, we didn't even have an album out. And we're just a new band from a small country. And, you know, we have a... We were asked, hey, what would you say if your song was in... an iPod commercial. They really like your song Around the Bend. You know, we had an EP at that point out, and they really liked that song. And we were like, yeah, sure, you know. And we thought, yeah, you know, we're not going to get that. It's one of the hugest commercials you can get at all. So we were like, yeah, sure, you know, people talk and nothing happens, you know that. So
yeah.
And then one night, my manager, he left a message on my machine saying, hey, okay, you know, you got it. It runs from tomorrow.
Oh, my God.
Okay, great. And then I, you know, had to buy my friends beers and stuff like that. So, you know, I think it's really cool, you know. This is a big sea of musicians, and everyone wants to come out at some point. You know, everything is expensive. You don't sell albums anymore, and who wants to listen to you? There's so many bands, you know. So I think it's really cool to be featured in different things with your music, because it makes you able to tickle people, you know, a little bit.
I love it.
That's saying, hey, we're here, and people look, maybe for a split second, but they might have the opportunity to fall in love with the rest of the music.